Dangerfield.
Alright, you bastards. So yesterday, while we were looking at that thing about the Margaret Thatcher statue, I mentioned that Kate Smurthwaite and his husband had appeared on British TV show Come Dine With Me. Now, this is going back 7 years. It was 2015. And I caught this by accident. I was just sitting at home, smashed out of my bonds. Just sort of... And then, of course, when I realised Smurthwaite was in it, I thought, this will be gold, because she's an anomaly. She doesn't exist in the same reality as other humans, largely due to her left-hard politics. And I thought, knowing that Come Dine With Me deliberately puts people in a social group with people they don't and won't and don't want to get on with, you know, they intentionally make it awkward and unpleasant, this should be good. Now, they all get a chance of cooking dinner for everyone, and they all go to each other's houses. I've skipped past the other two, I can't even remember, couples. But this is Kate and his husband doing their cooking for their guests that they clearly won't get on with, because that would be anyone from society. So let's go.
Quite different to ours. And yes, I'm feeling the pressure a little bit.
While James heats his starter, Andrew and Rob have made a discovery.
So what have we got here?
Are they in like a show together?
This is some kind of fringe theatre.
Yeah.
Superstar. Now, it's tricky taking this back. I'll see if that works. No. What you just saw there, let me see if I can. It's a bit of a risk, because every time you take it back... There you go. There you have Mr. and Mr. Smurthwaite dressed up as Egyptians. Now, this was, of course, before cultural appropriation was invented to smash white people over the head. And there's a somewhat... what's the word I'm looking for? Pukey, sensual picture of Kate with a glamorous dress and a knee up on his husband's charity shop suit. So you can already see this isn't going to go well. I mean, an Egyptian dance. I wonder if they'll actually perform that at the dinner party, because that would be exciting. That's the sort of thing you want after dinner, a couple of pricks dancing around pretending to walk like Egyptians. Let's go.
Yeah.
Are they in like a show together?
This is some kind of fringe theatre.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ Superstar.
More fringe than you'd ever know,
it's
mate.
A normal night in.
No one watches it. It's impressive, though. Her moustache has grown a bit more than usual, but, you know, crack on.
The mind boggles. Back in the kitchen, the soup's ready. James dishes up while Kate looks on.
Mr. Cuckswerve McCuckworthy.
Squash and smoked paprika soup.
What is butternut squash?
It's like a pumpkin. It's just a, you know, like a pumpkin.
Yeah, it's a vegetable.
So the couple on the left there, they're proper Essex types. When they, because I've seen this, when they introduced themselves, she went, "We're like the perfect Essex couple, like tits and teeth and wood tap, of course." The people here, they're a couple of homosexuals. They're quite good fun, actually. But it's the pair in the middle, Mr. and Mr. Smurthwaite, Cuckswervy McCuck, and Leftoid Bile Fountain, that we'll be paying most of our attention to.
But really eating soup at all.
Really?
I don't really like soup.
Flavour-wise, that's nice.
Like, it's just texture-wise.
You just don't like the salt.
Looks like it's already been... looks like it's already been eaten and, you know, brought back up. Maybe that's how they cooked it, in their stomachs. This pre-digested soup.
A liquidy thing.
Just think of it like a hot smoothie.
No, that's really tempting. Yeah, that's what I want. It's like, think of it like a hot smoothie. Is there such a thing as a hot smoothie? No. Why not? Because no one wants that. So just think of it as something really off-putting.
I think actually with Abby,
you know, she's got such a sort of naive palate that actually, like, the brilliant thing is that she will eat something if you can sell it to her in the right way.
Naive palate. I'm thinking that that fella's got a naive palate. I bet he don't go downstairs too often. Or he did once and, nah, never the twain shall meet again.
We're putting that in the dictionary next. Soup. Hot smoothie.
It's for a band as well, actually.
Hot smoothie.
Yeah. You're excellent.
I'm sort of wondering if when you've had soup before, it's been like out of a tin, somebody's opened a tin for you.
Wow, what incredible class hideousness. I'm guessing that if you've had soup before, it's come out of a tin. And then to add, someone's opened a tin for you. Vile creature.
Is that when you've mostly had soup?
I've never actually had anything out of a tin. That might be the reason why I haven't had soup.
Absolutely brutal. What? Hang on. Stop that, Channel 4. Just let me watch it illegally in another country.
I don't like tin things.
I thought Kate was very patronising towards Abby. It did make me...
Of course she was, because she's absolutely... go, you. Because she's devastatingly jealous that Abby is 100% wood tappable, and Smurthwaite in its wig is just a disgrace to the whole semiotics of attraction.
Cringe quite a lot.
I think Kate and James try and be a bit sarcastic, you know, say these kind of clever little comments. I don't get it. Feel threatened, so they try and put.
But they shouldn't be.
I think Abby had the upper hand because she didn't react.
They've all absolutely nailed it. Smurthwaite thinks she's above everyone, and yet everyone else in the room, except for Cucksworth McCuckington, knows that she's actually at the bottom of the pecking order. What a way to live!
To what she said.
I was really pleased that for the most part they ate it and they seemed like they really liked it, and I thought it came out just perfect. It was
spot on, yeah.
It was very, very tasty.
Mixed reviews for the safe starter. Onto something more adventurous.
I was just wondering, I was walking around the living room earlier, saw some lovely pictures.
Oh, yes.
Do you have some kind of, like, dressing up fetish?
There is this thing that people used to do in the 20s and 30s called sand dancing. It's like, have you heard of it? Yeah, okay, wow, fantastic. The woman who hasn't heard of butternut squash knows what sand dancing is.
So you know sand dancing, then?
Yeah, I did it at uni when I was doing cultural dance.
Oh, well done. Good girl.
You'll know what's coming, then.
Good girl. Now, yeah, you are not wrong. Look what they're doing at their dinner party. Look at that pair of pricks. They've actually come in dressed like that. I mean, you can feel the tension. This is disgusting. And they're going to do it. Oh, they're going to do it. I've seen it. Sit back. Strap yourselves in. Maybe get a pint of whiskey or something you can hit yourself over the head with. Because here it comes. This is what these two have practiced, rehearsed, taken photographs of, do as a thing, and it comprises part of their life. You fucking pricks. Here we go. Absolutely just cracking up. Immediately just cracking up. It's not meant to be a comedy performance, by the way. Sand dancing was never a comedy. Well, when I say never, I mean in 2015 in Smurthwaite and his husband's house it was. She's just brutal. Absolutely cracking up. Great work.
Oh, God.
No, amazing. Oh, God. And you can trust the gay. You can trust the gay to call anything. Gays are brutal. They were, you know, I lived in Soho. I was the only straight in the village. And he just said it. Oh, God. Check it. I mean, ask yourself, what did they expect the response to be? Ask yourself, what did they think the other people would get out of this? This is what I despise about a lot of performers. A lot of failed performers. And Mr. Smurthwaite is a failed performer, without a doubt. They do it for themselves. This is for themselves. They do this on their own. You know, no one's going to enjoy this. This is cringe-worthy. This is disgusting. This is just them. Oh, thanks. Can you? Is there anything for afters, or can you show me the door, please?
I can't deal with this.
No, she nailed it. Can't deal with this. She's just incredible. Can't deal with this. You see, what you've got is a couple of gays who always talk the truth because they've had a life where they've had to, and a couple of people who probably ain't the sharpest tools in the box, and yet because of that, will also talk the truth. And these middle-class wannabes, look at it. Look at that. It's giving me the shivers. She went, I can't deal with this. None of them can. No one who watched this, including you, will be able to deal with this. Because you why would you? It's embarrassing. It's low-grade humanity. Look at them, fuck's sake.
When I see someone that can't dance, like, it does make me borderline cringe.
It's not what I want to see before my dinner because it's just put me straight off.
That really did, like, you know, entertain me. It was great.
My heart sank a little bit.
Why?
I was a little bit like,
are you embarrassed?
Don't do this now.
Oh no!
I think that went well. I think that caught them by surprise. Yes.
Yeah, I don't think anyone was expecting that. Yeah.
No one was expecting that because you don't expect people to do such ridiculous things. Look at them still going. This was before dinner, I've just realised. For what reason?
Oh, good heavens.
Oh, I see what they've done. They've brought it into the modern age. They've turned it into a postmodern sand dance. Fuck's sake.
Yeah, don't call us, we'll call you.
You know that mad, so we've all been there, yay, yay, and it's the release valve, it's a thank fuck it's over, yeah, sit down you fucking pricks. Look at his boat race, this fella here, look. That isn't someone who's just enjoyed it, that's someone who's having trouble coming to terms with the actual behaviour of other humans. Look at him, look. Actually, like, no, don't stop it.
A quick costume change and James knuckles down to his dumplings while Kate looks on again.
Of course, she does nothing in that fam, in that relationship. She does nothing but tell him what to do because, you know, feminism.
Oh, wait a minute, though.
Oh, the smell is amazing, James. Ta-da-da-da.
The dumplings added and a further 20 minutes in the oven, the main course is ready.
Oh, wow.
Bar one.
I must admit, they do look like good dumplings. They're the only dumplings she's got I'd go near and all.
Final touch, the pomegranate seeds.
They're pretty bling. Maybe we can sell them to Abby as bling. It's food bling.
Bling venison
yeah,
stew.
Yeah, put your pomegranates in. That's what I want in my venison stew. Pomegranates.
Oh, yeah, look at it.
Venison. Oh, my God, look at the real poo on that. Real poo and potato sponge. Look at it. This is the idea of the show. To win a much-needed £1,000 for a failed comedian, why would you serve up... Why would you serve like that? Real poo and pomegranates with a... is that mashed potato and a dumpling? Nice one. Double carb.
Stew with skinny mash, but is it bling enough to win them the cash?
Okay, well this is Essex bling venison stew. I've never had.
I would so tap her if she come round and I took my crammer off and she went, love that! I'd probably smother her in seminal words and fluids.
Venison.
Haven't you? Ooh.
And I thought it was cow.
I believed him completely.
So we had a whole conversation. You know what it is now, though, don't you? Yes.
Do you remember Bambi?
Yeah. So tuck in and enjoy, please, people.
But I wouldn't worry.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, James.
I never thought I'd ever, ever, ever in my whole life eat a deer. Ever. And it's actually really nice, so do you know what?
Cheers.
Cheers, girl.
Cheers.
I'm eating something and eating.
Cheers, guys. Not the idiots who made it.
I'm watching TV and then, like, I see homeless people, not seeing anything. Mm. I know it's something stupid, but I can't eat my food.
I don't know, it's a trigger on my mind. Puts the connection off. So, like, even though it's stupid talking about Bambi or whatever, but it actually puts me off eating the food, so...
Are you going to finish the dumpling?
Can I have the dumpling, please?
You may have the dumpling.
Rob is itching for extra dumpling, I can sense.
Thank you, sir. Very kind.
Yeah, good man.
Would you like some more Bambi too?
Oh, stop it, you! Stop it!
Bambi there, look!
I don't know why I'm on the comedy circuit. This man is hilarious.
You ain't on the comedy circuit.
They start saying, how's Bambi? That is just a no-go for me.
No, I think you're right as well. It's a ridiculous thing to say. You know, it's like serving up some meat and going, how's your dead dog?
Get me out of here.
Yeah.
Please.
Definitely.
I think it was a brave dish because, you know, it was not everyone's cup of tea.
It's a fucking brave moustache, you ponce.
A couple of days ago, we're all strangers and hedging our bets and who's not...
And they are certainly never going to call you again.
Nice and who's going to be the problem ones and didn't have to look at you and say who...
And it's been you too.
Who's nice and who's going to be the problem ones.
It's been interesting on, I think, our part as well. I obviously...
Massive jugs.
I've got complete different...
Massive jugs, well presented.
Outlook on life to you or what you're interested in or what your views are and...
Yeah, because she's mental and he's just the whipping boy.
It's kind of actually knowledge from you has been quite interesting on our part.
I don't think I've ever met people quite like you before. Like,
what, working class? Fuck off, Al, I met your father. He's dead, you cheeky cunts.
like you're not the kind of people who I meet in a normal day-to-day basis.
It's been really lovely to have like an insight into a world that I've never put a toe in before.
I don't even know how you define those people. They're just normal working class people, and that is the definition: normal working class people. Yeah, she's never been near them, fears them, doesn't understand them, despises them. Like the left do in general. No surprises there.
I'm really sort of grateful for having the opportunity to meet people like that, because we just...
You patronising witch.
Wouldn't. They're not the sort of people we usually run into.
Kate, she kind of thinks that we're two children, I think. She don't realise that there's other people out there who've experienced just as much or even more than her. And
absolutely nailed it. Incredible. You know, she basically has said that, you know, oh, we don't usually hang around with idiots from Essex. Much more insight, much more honest, less trying to perform, less trying to put on some kind of, I'm like this, I do this, I'm like this. No, he's just himself, and it's a far more attractive, far more credible, far more enjoyable, and makes him a nicer person.
In a lifetime, I think.
Best leave it there. Dessert, and James sprinkles crumble topping over reduced pears before baking.
James still cooking.
You can guess what Kate's doing.
I really thought something...
Looking exceptionally unpleasant.
Has to go wrong, you know. Like, you know, because there's all this extra pressure. Something is bound to crack. And
yeah, it cracked, mate, when you started poncing around in your charity shop Egyptian clothes.
I actually think that we've done it. So proud of you. Yeah. You're awesome.
Yeah, you haven't won.
I couldn't have done it without you.
You could very...
Did you see that little micro expression where he looked up to his happy past before this witch was controlling his life?
Easily have done it without me.
In fact, he did. And it's ready. Pear and ginger crumble.
This is a crumble, but with a twist, because it's pear instead of apple.
Mm-hmm.
And I've gone for the ginger instead of the cinnamon.
Oh, what an amazing twist. No one's had pear crumble before. What? There's only one crumble in there. Yeah, I'm not going to go there.
This is absolutely flawless. It's amazing.
I don't actually like pear, so...
It ain't that difficult to cook some pears and put some fucking biscuit crumb on it, though, is it? Let's be fair.
I'm going to have a little try again.
Do try.
Maybe next time we have Abby around for dinner, we'll do the meal for everyone and then...
Yeah, she's never coming around again. She despises you two freaks, as do the gays.
We'll just do Abby with when we're all having pear and ginger crumb, we'll get you a pear jelly bean and a ginger jelly bean. Maybe there's a crumble jelly bean.
Yeah, you just keep patronising. You keep on infantilising her. Because I can assure you, Mr. Smurthwaite, out of the entire population, 99.9% of people will spend a few hours with her than you. Give her some sweets because she's a child. She looks far, far more the woman than you. Let me tell you that.
Chips flavoured jelly bean.
Yeah, go on, keep milking it. Just feed her sweets, you cheeky, patronising pair of pricks.
Sure they'll be here next time.
Oh, I think we rocked.
Did you see that face? I've got to risk it. I know it's a bit difficult round here, but let's have a look at that boat again, don't I? Yeah.
Do try.
Maybe next time we have Abby round for dinner, we'll do the meal for everyone, and then we'll just do Abby with one. when we're all having pear and ginger, yeah. Come, we'll get you a pear jelly bean and a ginger jelly.
Look at the way she's addressing the gaze while she's in, you know, shockingly infantilizing that other lovely woman. She's addressing the gaze while she's talking about her. Awful. Oh, what an awful, cretinous witch.
Maybe there's a crumble jelly bean.
Flavoured jelly bean
steak
and chips flavoured jelly bean.
Yeah, go on. You've got it. You've milked it. It's going to turn to butter in a minute.
Not sure they'll be here next time.
I mean, look. Oh, whoa. There you go. That's what you do to someone when in a room full of adults, you treat them like a fucking five-year-old. That's how you make them feel. She's always talking about women's rights and human rights and fucking blah, blah, blah. Look at that. Look how she's made that woman feel by essentially telling her, you've got no culture, you've got no sense of style or taste, you're essentially a child. What a fucking horrible thing to say to someone. And this comes from someone whose hair looks like she's just... like she lives under the water in some kind of fucking cave and she's come out and there's seaweed hanging off it. She hasn't even fucking washed her hair this year before going on telly. And, you know, what... And she pranced around in her fucking Egyptian suit. Gangnam-style sand dance. And you're telling this bird that she's got to have fucking jelly beans, you... obnoxious bitch.
Time.
Oh, I think we rocked the night, to be very honest with you.
I think you didn't.
I love the fact that this has given him a chance to shine and a chance for people to see what an...
Oh my God, the cucking continues. I love cooking. I love him cooking has given him a chance to shine, which would suggest he doesn't get that chance anywhere else in their relationship. Can't imagine why. I wonder who wears the trousers.
Amazing cookie is.
I'm being biased, I think. I enjoyed our food the most because it's what we
yeah, we like
our menu,
food.
So I'm being honest.
Me and Stephen are still going to come third.
I would spend an evening with the bird with the cans and her fella first, the gaze second, and I just wouldn't spend a night with Smurthwaite. No. She refused to do a panel show with me once at the Edinburgh Festival. She said I was too misogynist. Too misogynist. What's just enough misogyny? It was good though, because then the other people that were meant to be doing the show, they walked out as well because they were like, fuck you. So that panel show didn't happen. Well done, Kate. Yeah,
Confidence.
Rob and Abby are definitely going to come first, and James and Kate are going to come second.
Let's find out. James and Kate need 27 to steal the win from Rob and Abby.
We've had a great, entertaining night, but the food wasn't...
Well, let's see. I'll be honest with you. I can't remember who wins this little competition, so I'm kind of excited.
As good as last night.
Therefore, we're going to give James and Kate a 16.
We're going to give James and Kate...
Hold it there! It's up to the host to reveal the winners.
OK, people. In third place, Andrew and Stephen.
The gays got better things to do than sit around cooking for strangers they don't like.
It's an absolute travesty. Second place, Rob and Abigail.
Oh, fucking hell. Those fucking ponces won it because the gays felt sorry for them. Got it.
What does that mean?
A 12 from Rob and Abby made James and Kate winners by 2 points.
Thank you, guys. Hopefully we can...
The most unpleasant potential orgy I've ever seen just occurred there.
keep in contact and keep...
Yeah, massive. That's just moved up a bit. Just a little palate cleanser for the end there. Right, I've got something I've got to go and do rather rapidly. Ta-da!
Sweet!